Coming up now, it's the bronze medal match in the recurve women's team event, and it's Ukraine going up against Switzerland. Both the Swiss and the Ukrainian fans looking forward to this match. Well, there we have it, confirmation of the set points going to Ukraine, winning that set 36-29. Well, here we go. Set three here, and Switzerland under the cosh. 24-year-old Iliana Deneko will shoot first for the Swiss team. Nine. That's better. Still a bit right for Deneko. That's Olga Fusek dialed in here. Left again and back in the six ring. Rodionova up for Ukraine.
Nine.
She's into the nine. It's a very, very confident Ukrainian pairing here. Solid form, quick release there, and a good grouping as well. Kachina puts hers right next to her teammates. Big wobble there.
Eight.
Gets away with an eight. Loads of movement from Fusek as well. And she puts that into an eight as well. So their highest score so far from Switzerland, 31, but still very gettable. Rodionova has taken all the pressure off her teammate by shooting her second arrows both into the 10 ring. She gets a nine this time, and that's three nines in a row. The set is here for the taking, along with the match. 4 points is all that's required. And she puts it on the 9-10 ring, gets the 10 points. And a 37 is more than enough for the set points.
For Ukraine, that means after the official confirmation of the score.
Handshakes all around on the shooting line, because 6 points, 2 points per set for Ukraine is more than enough for a very, very confident and comfortable win for Irina Kachina, who's just 24 years old, and the 25-year-old Polina Rodionova. And as you can hear, the stadium announcer telling everyone the bronze medal in the recurve women's team event goes to Ukraine. Well, there we have confirmation of a one-sided victory for Ukraine, taking the bronze medal 6-0 over Switzerland. Coming up now, it's time to decide who's going to get the gold medal here in the recurve women's team event. Well, there we have it, confirmation of the scores in the second set. 38 points out of a possible 40 for Korea, 32 for the Russian Federation. Korea take the second set and lead 4-0. So the Russian Federation will shoot first. Back over to Valeria Milnikova, representing the Transbaikal State University of Chita. She puts it up into the seven. over to Gombaeva from Buryat State University of Ulan Ud. Matt in the X ring. There are 17. The best start that pairing have had. Chang Chae-young representing the graduate school, sorry, King Hee Cyber School and University of Seoul. Shooting first for Korea. And that's in the 10 ring. Over to Choi Mi-soon, who's here representing the graduate school of Gwangju Women's University of Gwangju. That's a good shot there from Milnikova. Can Svetlana Gombaeva put some pressure on the Koreans here? Gets on the line and she gets a 10. That's a 37, the best score by far for the Russian Federation. 39 possible for Kang and Choi, though.
Nine.
To the nine ring. So now a target of 38 is possible. They only need to get level with the Russian Federation on 37 points. Eight. And that is an eight. And they get 36. They needed the nine there. And the Russian Federation sneak the third, and they're back in the match. Trailing still 4-2, but a good fight back from Gombaeva and Milnikova. Question is, will they challenge the nine from Kang, the second arrow? We shall wait and see. Well, on the measure, the points have been changed. And that is not confirmed there. Korea have actually been marked up to a 37, and they get the set points. And that's what they needed. In fact, it was Russia who got marked down to a nine on that second arrow. Bit of confusion around the field of play, but I can confirm now the first Russian arrow from Gombaeva was marked from a 10 down to a nine. That put them on 36 points. That's the target that Korea got. And it means that they level on points and get the gold medal, winning it 5-1. So gold for Korea. And the 23-year-old Choi Mi-soon and Kang Chae-young will be on the top step of the podium very soon, right in front of this beautiful royal castle in Caserta. And there is the confirmation of that scores. The second arrow from the Russian Federation marked from a 10 down to a 9, which means both teams finished on 36 points. They share the two set points, a target of 5 reached by Korea, who are the champions of the recurve women's team event. So they were the red hot favourites here, and they stood up to the test as well throughout the competition. On the right, it's Kang Chae Young from the Kyunghee Cyber University of Seoul. She's the world number one. And on the left, it's Choi Mi-sun from the Graduate School of Gwangju Women's University of Gwangju. Gwangju, of course, the host city for the 2015 Summer Universiade, the 28th edition. Well, there we have it, confirmation that Korea are the champions in the women's recurve team event here at Napoli 2019. They beat Russia to gold, the Russian Federation picking up the silver, and it's Ukraine with the bronze medal. That's the women's team event done here on Recurve Saturday, coming up very soon. We'll switch over to the Recurve men's team as Korea get their chance to shine in the spotlight here in Caserta in front of the Royal Palace. Time now for the Recurve men's team bronze medal match. Well, there we have it, confirmation, those four nines giving the USA 36 points in the third set, and coming from a 2-0 deficit, the USA now lead 4-2. They will shoot second, and the Farber brothers now have to put down a marker that's high enough to put the USA team under pressure, because all Height and Zumbo have to do is match the Swiss to take the bronze medal. Floria Farber on the shooting line for Switzerland.
Nine.
Good grouping by the Swiss pair. We move over to target two. And Matthew Zumbo.
Nine.
Well, like I said, all the USA need to do is match the Swiss, and that's exactly what they've done here. One set point enough to take the bronze medal. Floria Farber on the shooting line. Win behind him. Puts it out into the eight ring. Adrian was quite happy with that one, but they've set a target of 35. And again, quite gettable for Zumbo and Height. Zumbo on the line.
Nine.
So they only need an eight to draw a level and get the point required for bronze. Anything more and they'll take both points and win 6-2. Oh, it's on the 8-9 line. They'll get a 9 and it's another 36 for the USA. They've come from two set points down in this bronze medal match and then won the next three sets with some comfort. USA are the bronze medalists in the recurve men's team event here at Napoli 2019. Confirmation of the final scores. The USA trailed after the first set, but then fought back strongly to win the bronze medal 6-2 over Switzerland. Well, coming up here in Caserta. It's the recurve men's team gold medal match between the Russian Federation and Chinese Taipei. Well, there we have confirmation, the two teams matching each other arrow for arrow in that second set, and it means the Russian Federation hold their two-point lead, 3-1 in the gold medal match in the recurve men's team event. And it's Chinese Taipei and Tang Qichun to shoot first in the third. Quickly up to the line, this Chinese Taipei pairing. Wei Chunheng swapping over with Tang Qichun. Another nine, and the reason for mentioning that is it means it buys them a lot more time in their second two arrows. Time pressure, the enemy of the anchor archer in team matches. Lichto Singuev shooting an eight. Total for the 4 hours for each team. And a lovely 10 means they're all level on points. Back over to the 18-year-old Tang on target number two. And a 10 for him. And you could hear the coach shouting, nice shot, as soon as the arrow was released. And a nine there. This is good stuff from Chinese Taipei. They're fighting back here. They've set a target of 37. Back over to Singuev. Oh, great shot there. A 10 here will win it for the Russian Federation. Adem Siripov puts it into the X ring. What a shot from him to finish this match off in style. It's subject to confirmation, but a 38 point target set from the Russian Federation up against what Chinese Taipei put down the range of 37. And this is not just a surprise, but it's the measure of the win here for the Russian Federation that's so impressive against a team that boasts the world number 22 and the world number 32. Chinese Taipei look on, Wei Chunheng on the left, Tang Qichun on the right, but I think this is done. And it is confirmed, a magical victory for the Russian Federation. They take out the much fancied Chinese Taipei 5-1. Hats off to Erdem Siripov and Belikto Singuev. They are the gold medalist in the recurve men's team event. Chinese Taipei and Tang and Wei having to settle for silver. What a brilliant performance from the Russian Federation. Well, there is confirmation of that 38-37 score in the third set. And the Russian Federation taking the gold over Chinese Taipei. Well, having fought their way through against Germany and the USA, Chinese Taipei would have fancied themselves to take the gold, but they were blown away by their opponents in the gold medal match. They'll look back on this with a smile. It's the 19-year-old Tang Qichun representing the National Taipei University of New Taipei City. It's a photo op for the recurve men's team's medalist. Russia, top of the pile, beating Chinese Taipei in the gold medal match. The USA taking out Switzerland for bronze. And it's time for their moment in the sun in front of the Royal Palace. Well, coming up now, it's time for the recurve mixed team gold medal match here in front of the Royal Palace in Caserta, and it's Japan versus Chinese Taipei. Well, confirmation, the set point shared in the third set. 34 shot down the range by both teams. They are level at 3-3. And Peng Jiama of Chinese Taipei on target two will shoot first in the fourth and final set into the X ring. A great start. 25-year-old teammate Wei Chun-Hing for the second arrow for Chinese Taipei. Quick release into the nine. Up steps the 20-year-old Yuta Ishii. Response from Yuta Ishii. He held on to that one for perhaps a little longer than the Japanese team would have liked, but Risa Horiguchi can get the arrows out quickly once she's set. And she does indeed. And she has shot a nine. Japan are matching Chinese Taipei here. Peng just has to go through her process and forget about emotion. Put the pressure on Japan with a big score. Oh, brilliant X from her. And now over to Wei Chun-Hing, the 25-year-old. He's got plenty of time. Quick release, and he's into the 10 ring. So now Japan require two 10s, a 39 when the pressure was on from Chinese Taipei, showing their class, dropping just one point in the final set. Tens required for Japan. It's in the nine. That's gone. It's gone already. Risa Horiguchi shooting for honor here. Oh, a lovely shot from her into the X ring. Any arrows marked down from Chinese Taipei or up for Japan would change the result here. But confirmation from the target judge. 39 out of 40 for Chinese Taipei gives them the match. 5-3. Peng Chia Mao and Wei Chun Heng take gold for Chinese Taipei in the mixed team. And there is confirmation. Great scores from both teams in the fourth. They had to bring their A game to take the gold, and that's just what they did, shooting a 39 out of 40 in the final set. The gold medal in the mixed team recurve event goes to Chinese Taipei. Well, brilliant performance from all three. Chinese Taipei take the gold in the recurve mixed team event from a game Japan, who pick up silver, and it's Ukraine with the bronze medal and their chance to shine in the sun and their photos in front of this brilliant backdrop of the Royal Palace in Caserta.